The Good Samaritan is a parable or a story that Jesus told. And this parable appears in the Gospel of Luke, chapter 10. So let's set the scene. In Luke 10, we read that an expert in the law, the Holy Law or Torah this would be, stood up to ask Jesus a question. This expert was probably a Pharisee. Now, Pharisees kept themselves separate from people. They wouldn't have anything to do with foreigners, and they even wouldn't have anything to do with the poor or uneducated of their own tribe. They were very concerned with keeping to the Holy Law. A Pharisee would probably only consider another Pharisee as their neighbour. So it appears here that this expert was trying to catch Jesus out, and he starts with asking him a question about how he can get to heaven. Jesus turns his trick question back on him by asking what the expert understands of the law. The expert can quickly and easily recite the point Jesus wants him to. He clearly is an expert. He says, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your strength, and with all your mind, and love your neighbour as yourself." "Well done," says Jesus, "you've got it. Do what this says and you're sorted." But the expert still wanted to catch Jesus out, so he asks who Jesus is saying his neighbour is, even though he probably had a very clear idea in his own expert head who he thought his neighbour was. This is when Jesus tells him a parable. Jesus said a man was walking from one town to another through the countryside when a gang of thugs fell on him and attacked him. They hurled insults at him. "You get lost. You're not from round here. You don't belong. What are you doing here anyway?" The thugs ran off and left the poor man lying on the ground. A short while later, a church leader came past. He was a very busy man and he really didn't want to get involved. He was on his way to a very big and important meeting. He did notice the poor man on the ground, but he kept his eyes averted and crossed over to the other side to avoid him. In the Bible, this man is a priest. Now, priests were probably Pharisees, and they weren't supposed to come into contact with a dead body because they thought they would become impure, even if their shadow touched a dead body. But this man wasn't dead. That was rather a poor excuse. In a little while along came a policeman. Now this policeman may have been on his way to arrest some very bad criminals, so he really didn't have time to stop. If he hurried, he might be able to catch up with the rest of the gang. He thought that the man on the ground would even be part of the gang. In the Bible, this man was a Levite, a lawman. He wouldn't have had such a concern with keeping pure as the Pharisee would. He was more of an ordinary Jew. But would he save the day? He didn't. He was more concerned with his own interpretation of the law. A while later, along came the Samaritan. Samaritans were an ethnically mixed nation and had both Jewish and pagan heritage. For hundreds of years, the Jews and the people of Samaria had been enemies. The Samaritans had built their own temple, but the Jews thought this was pagan. There was a huge feud which grew and grew. And by the time of Jesus, the Jews hated the Samaritans so much that they would go out of their way to avoid even going into Samaria. When the Samaritan saw the man on the ground, he didn't hesitate. He got off his donkey and he went over to see what he could do to help. He managed to bandage up the worst bits and put balm or oil on some of the worst areas. Then very carefully, he helped the man onto his donkey The donkey couldn't carry both of them, so the Samaritan steadied the man on the donkey and walked all the way to the next town beside him. Later, the Samaritan helped the man settle into an inn and paid for the room. He asked the innkeeper to look after the man and to get him whatever he needed. The Samaritan would pay for it all. What was important to the Samaritan was that the man was cared for and he got better. He was very worried about him and just wanted to do whatever he could do to help. At the end of the parable, Jesus asked the expert, which one of these three people on the road was a neighbour to the man who was attacked? There could be no doubt about it. No argument could stand. It was the only one who had shown mercy. It was the Samaritan. Jesus' advice to the expert is very simple. He told the expert to go and do likewise. Jesus is being very radical here. It's very clear that the rescuer wasn't Jewish, so this parable is clearly anti-racism. Jesus gives the starring role, the rescuer, the one who saves the day, to an enemy, to someone the hearers of the story would hate and someone who the hearers of the story would not forgive for simply being of a different race. So this parable is clearly about God accepting all people. Jesus has a clear world view here. He's very emphatically saying everyone is our neighbour, not just those from our own race, our own culture, our own way of doing things. We are all part of God's family. Within this, the parable of the Good Samaritan is also about forgiveness. Forgiveness and acceptance or welcome. Definitely forgiveness and love. If you consider someone your neighbour, you need to love them. There are direct instances in the Bible where Jesus forgives somebody who's Samaritan. Remember the Samaritan woman at the well. But the important point here is that Jesus forgives her for her sin. She had no need, and Jesus saw no need for her to be forgiven for being a Samaritan. God isn't interested in race or difference or points of law. He is interested in people. And the woman at the well sees Jesus for who he is. In John 4:29, she says, "Come, see a man who told me everything I ever did." Could this be the Messiah? Jesus is the Messiah. Perhaps we don't have a problem with racism. Maybe there are other groups of people we might make judgments on, though. Other groups of people we might find it hard to forgive and accept and love. The question is, who is the Samaritan for you? It might be someone from another ethnic group, or just someone who is different from you. It might be a group of people, for instance, a corrupt politician, or people who have murdered, or people who harm children. Or it might be a person who has wronged you personally in some way. Who do we find it difficult to accept, difficult to forgive, and difficult to love? And the other important point is that person might also be you yourself. Sometimes we find it so hard to forgive ourselves for something we've done or something we've thought or simply for being the way we are. But Jesus came to this world to die for our sins. He died for our wrongdoing. He took all of it from all of us on himself when he died. He defeated it. And when he rose again victorious, he gave us victory, freedom, and peace. We don't need to hold on to unforgiveness, either for ourselves or for others who have wronged us. We are all forgiven if we accept what Jesus did for us. There's an old hymn that talks about Jesus washing our sins away. Our sins are gone. The hurt is gone. The pain is gone. We are free. Jesus saved us not only for an eternity in heaven, but also for today. We are not bound by unforgiveness. We are totally and completely free. We are loved, accepted, and change when we allow Jesus to touch us. Praise God for these parables that Jesus told. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for what the parables show us of you and for how they show us Jesus and why he came and where we will be if we believe in him. Thank you that because of Jesus, we are your children, loved, safe, and secure. Amen.